Good evening all. Today we will have one basic concept, the background study of module 2. What all you are going to study in your module 2? If you just go through your syllabus, it is the time domain representation of LTI system. This is the heading of the module 2. In this, what is LTI you should know? L stands for linear, TI stands for, this is T, okay? TI stands for time invariant. So this linear and time invariant, in the previous module 1, the system properties we have studied. Some 6 properties we have studied, out of which these 2 properties, the linearity and time invariance. Okay, those two, a system which has these 2 properties, fulfilling, such system we will consider here. The system should be linear, means in the sense law of superposition should hold good. If input is sum of inputs x1, x2, x3, x1 plus x2 plus x3, output will also be what? y1 plus y2 plus y3. And the time invariance, if you shift your input by some amount, say t0 or n0, output y will also get shifted by the same amount, n0 or t0. So these 2 properties should hold good for a system here, time domain representation for LTI systems. The systems which satisfy linearity and time invariance, these 2 properties, we call them LTI systems. In short, LTI. Time domain representation. So what do you mean by time domain representation? We have got 2 domains, obviously. Even in mathematics, you might have studied, or you might be studying still regarding the Fourier, Laplace, and even Z transforms. All they represent, transforms, Fourier transforms, they represent frequency domain representation. Okay, here we are talking about time domain representation. No doubt in your next future module, you will be studying the frequency domain as well. But here it is a time domain representation. So what do you mean by time domain representation? It is the relation between output signal and the input signal when both these signals are functions of time. Time is the parameter here. But in case of frequency domain representation, F will be the parameter, frequency. Okay. Now you should decide which representation is feasible for our calculations and in practice, whether time domain analysis is important or frequency domain analysis is important. It's up to you. LTI systems are easy to analyze. That's why here, whatever we work on the functions which are with respect to time, we will consider the systems as they are linear and they are time invariant. So LTI systems, they are easy to analyze. There are 3 different methods to represent LTI systems. This time domain representation, we can have it in 3 different ways. One is in terms of impulse response. Impulse is a known term to you already. You might have studied it in your network theory. And even in module 1, we have studied what is impulse signal. So what do you mean by impulse signal? If you take the continuous time signal, this delta of t represents impulse signal at point 0. That is at time t equals to 0. This indicates arrow mark. The amplitude is not 1. It arrow mark, it extends up to infinity. This is your impulse signal in case of continuous time. In case of discrete time, this is delta of n at time n equals to 0. And the amplitude we consider 1 for discrete. Okay. So these are impulse signals. So now what do you mean by impulse response? Response, it is a synonym which we use for output. So the another name for output is response. So whenever the question is find the response, it is nothing but find the output. Then second way of representing the LTI system is either using difference or differential equations. Differential equation, it's again a very familiar term to you. you might have studied about differential equations, homogeneous equation, heterogeneous equations, finding the solution of the equation, auxiliary equation, you know, all those equations you have studied. Differential equation, it is applicable to continuous time. And the difference equation, it is applicable to discrete time. Fine. And third way of representing the LTI system is block diagram representation. So these are three ways we will be studying in this module 2. The complete module 2 covers these three things: impulse response representation, differential difference equation representation, and the block diagram. In block diagram, again, direct one form and direct two forms are there. So first, let us start with the impulse response representation. So you should know, what do you mean by impulse response first? I have just now explained you what is an impulse. Impulse means the signal delta, and response indicates the output. Okay. Now all together, what do you mean by impulse response? Let us try to understand. If this is the block, say any system, okay, this is one LTI system, that the condition for this is we should have LTI system. So this is one LTI system, means it obeys linearity and time invariance property. Then suppose you have the input, say either x of t or x of n, and you have the output y of t or y of n. If this is the case, if you apply the input as impulse signal delta of t or delta of n, whatever, either continuous or discrete, if you take the input as impulse signal, then whatever output you get, we denote it as small h. H, small h indicates impulse response. H of, here I have taken continuous time, delta of t, hence it is h of t. If I take delta of n, I will get h of n. So this h of n or h of t is called impulse response of the system. Response means what? It is the output. Output of the system when the input is impulse signal. It's we know the word means this, it is directly given. The meaning is given directly. Output of the system when the input is impulse signal. So this is the meaning of impulse response. That's what I've written here. It is the output of the LTI system when the input applied is impulse, either delta of t or delta of n. And these two are present at what time? Time t is equal to 0 or n is equal to 0. This is the definition of impulse response, impulse output. Okay. Now important part comes. In impulse response, we will mainly deal with this particular concept, which I'm going to deal now. You just look at the screen very carefully. I have shared it. Try to understand this. You can see it. Any signal x of n, I have started with the discrete time. Okay. The same thing can be applicable to continuous time as well. I have started with discrete. I have considered one signal x of n. And this signal can be represented in terms of, see, shifted impulses. What do you mean by shifted impulses? Impulse means what? I'm taking discrete, so I'll take delta of n. If this is the impulse, shifted impulses means what? Shifting, n minus 1, n plus 1, n minus 2, like that. So what is the statement given? Any signal can be represented in terms of shifted impulses. So, agar koi signal aapko diye hain x of n, hum isko in terms of delta represent kar sakte hain, the meaning of the statement. How? Let us see with one example. This example will never be asked anywhere in your questions, but this example is important for you to understand the concept. I have taken one example. You can see it on the screen. X of n. It has got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 different samples are there at between minus 2 to plus 2. See, yahan par amplitude minus 1 hai. Here it is 2, 2, 1. And here it is 0.5. Assume some amplitudes are existing here. 5 samples are there. Now, according to the above statement, what is the statement? any signal can be represented in terms of shifted impulses. So क्या हम इस x of n signal को delta के form में represent कर सकते हैं? That is the question. Let us try to do it. Okay? If you just break this given signal x of n into parts, we have got 5 parts. At each time, consider one sample. See, at minus 2, you have one signal, 1 point, one amplitude. Then at minus 1, you have one more amplitude. Here at 0, one more. Likewise, agar aap x of n signal ko split karenge, 5 parts mein, okay, 5 different amplitude values it has at 5 different time values. So what I will do, first I will take first part, this one, minus 2. At time minus 2, you can see amplitude is minus 1. So what I will do, I will take a signal here, okay? This signal at point minus 2, right? Here it is minus 1, here it is 0, like that. Yahan par amplitude aapka minus 1 hai. Now, how can I get this? This can be got by multiplying. Ye sample humko kaise milega? Ye jo aapka original signal x of n hai. What is n value? N is minus 2. So, take the sample value at minus 2 and multiply it with delta of n plus 2. What is delta of n plus 2? This is your delta, right? This is your delta of n. Now, what is delta of n plus 1? It will get shifted to the left side. So, n plus 1 yahan pe aayega. What is delta of n plus 2? N plus 2 means at minus 2, aapka signal rahega, amplitude 1. So, this represents delta of n plus 2. ये जो आपका सिग्नल एम्पलीट्यूड है टाइम माइनस टू पे क्या है दैट इज माइनस वन ये जो माइनस वन एम्पलीट्यूड है ये वैल्यू सिग्नल का ये वैल्यू एंड इफ यू मल्टीप्लाई दैट विद द डेल्टा ऑफ एन प्लस टू ये भी वन ही है ओके इट इज नथिंग बट यू आर मल्टीप्लाइंग एक्स ऑफ माइनस टू वैल्यू जो आपका माइनस वन है गिवन सिग्नल मल्टीप्लाइंग बाय वन इटसेल्फ राइट एक्स डेल्टा ऑफ एन प्लस टू मीन्स वॉट यहाँ पर एम्पलीट्यूड वन है सो वी कैन रिप्रेजेंट ओरिजिनल सिग्नल एक्स ऑफ एन दिस सैंपल बाय दिस एक्स ऑफ माइनस टू ये जो सैंपल वैल्यू है एक्स ऑफ माइनस टू मल्टीप्लाई बाय डेल्टा ऑफ एन प्लस टू डेल्टा ऑफ एन प्लस टू का एम्पलीट्यूड वन रहेगा वन इंटू एक्स ऑफ माइनस टू सेम एम्पलीट्यूड हमको आएगा सिमिलरली ये हो गया फर्स्ट पार्ट ओके आउट ऑफ 5 1 2 3 4 5 फर्स्ट वन हो गया नाउ लेट अस कम टू द सेकंड पार्ट यहां पर आपका एम्पलीट्यूड 2 है एट माइनस 1 हियर आई हैव शोन इट हाउ कैन आई राइट दिस सिग्नल द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द सिग्नल इज टेक द सिग्नल्स एम्पलीट्यूड एट माइनस 1 सी एट माइनस 1 जो भी आपका x सिग्नल का एम्पलीट्यूड है दैट इज 2 It should be multiplied with delta of n plus 1. What do you mean by delta of n plus 1? This is your delta of n. So delta of n plus 1 means somewhere here. Minus 1 pe signal rahega. This is your delta of n plus 1. It means again aap ye jo signal amplitude hai aapka 2. X of minus 1 means what? 2. Isko aap 1 se multiply kar rahe ho. That's it. This is the second signal. Now the third bit you see at 0. You can see again यहाँ पर भी आपका amplitude 2 है, okay? In the given signal. So what I will do, this signal, I can get this part by multiplying the signal at a time t equals to 0 multiplied by delta of n. What is delta of n? यहाँ पर delta of n value 1 रहेगा at time 0. So it is nothing but x of 0 value, जो amplitude 2 है, multiplied by 1. Right? So again, next, यहाँ पर fourth sample we will take. This fourth sample here, I can write this as the signal amplitude at time 1, क्या है? That is 1. 1 multiplied by, हमको ये position चाहिए. I want this position of the delta. Original position of the delta is here. So if I want this position, I have to shift to the right side by 1 amount. This will become delta of n minus 1. So I will multiply it by delta of n minus 1. Delta of n minus 1 का amplitude 1 ही रहेगा. So same signal repeat होगा. Right? And the fifth part you can see, यहाँ पर, if I assume it as 0.5 amplitude, here you can see it. You check the time value is 2. How can I get the signal? I should take the signal amplitude at a time t equals to 2. उसका amplitude 0.5 रहेगा. Multiplied by, मुझे अभी ये पॉइंट चाहिए 1, 2, 0. सो आई वॉन्ट दिस पॉइंट. ओरिजिनली डेल्टा ऑफ एन 0 पे रहता है. इफ आई वॉन्ट द वैल्यू एट 2, आई शुड शिफ्ट डेल्टा ऑफ एन बाय टू द राइट साइड बाय 2 अमाउंट्स. सो डेल्टा ऑफ एन माइनस 2, आई शुड मल्टीप्लाई इट विथ डेल्टा ऑफ एन माइनस 2. इट इज नथिंग बट एक्स ऑफ 2 क्या आएगा, 0.5 है एम्पलीट्यूड, मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 1. So again, you will get 0.5 itself. So how can I represent this complete signal x of n, जिसमें 5 samples हैं, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These 5 samples, individually, I can get how? By, in terms of shifted impulses, delta of n plus 2, n plus 1, n, n minus 1, n minus 2. Individually, each sample, I can get it in this form. So if I want, finally, if I add all, we have already seen how signals are added. You try to add all these signals, what will be the outcome? At minus 2, amplitude minus 1 hai, ye aa jayega. Then at minus 1, aapka amplitude 2 hai, all other zeros hai. So 0 plus that value 2, second sample aayega. Likewise, at 0, you have 2. Then at 1, you have amplitude 1. And finally at 2, amplitude 0.5. So if you add all these signals, you will get the original signal back. Or I have split this x of n in 5 different components. Okay. So finally, how can I write x of n? It is the summation of all 5. We are adding all signals, right? All 5 components which we have split. We will add all. Okay. Here you can see it. Ye jo signal hai, these parts. All we are adding together mathematically. And pictorially, if you just add all amplitudes, aapko ye original signal wapis aa jayega. So how can I write it? It is x of n is equal to sum of all this. Can I just, write this in a summation form? Just try to see. I can take here, you can observe all has got x and all has got delta. So, ek signal aapka x rahega, ek signal aapka delta rahega. And you can observe, yahan par jo x ke time values hain, wo vary ho rahe hain minus 2 se plus 2 tak. So, I will just take the summation range between minus 2 to plus 2 and I will put that variable. You can take any variable. I have taken k here. You can take m and anything. So I have taken k here and there is n constant. Observe it. Yahan par n constant hai. First term, ye bhi aapka, yes, n plus 1. It is actually not delta of 0. It is delta of n. Okay. Please, it's a mistake. Correct it. It is delta of n. And here it is n. So first term aapka delta of n constant hai. Minus, ye jo values hai. ब्रैकेट के वैल्यूज, ओके, यहाँ पर 0 है, 1, 1, 2, 2, सो द सेम वैल्यूज आर अपीयरिंग हियर, सो दैट के आई हैव रिटन. ये जो आपका समेशन है, सम है, जो एक्सपांडेड फॉर्म है, मैंने उसको एक सम फॉर्म में लिख लिया है, फॉर्मूला के फॉर्म में लिखा है. ओके, नाउ इफ आई जस्ट मेक दिस इक्वेशन वन जनरल इक्वेशन, एक जनरल सिग्नल है आपके पास एक्स ऑफ एन, उसके लिए अगर मुझे लिखना है, हाउ कैन आई मेक इट, जस्ट चेंज द लिमिट फ्रॉम माइनस टू प्लस इंफिनिटी. इफ आई डू द चेंजेस, नाउ इफ आई कंसीडर अ सिस्टम व्हिच इज एलटीआई सिस्टम एंड इफ दिस टी इज वन ऑपरेटर, वी डोंट नो व्हाट इट इज वन ऑपरेटर, इनपुट इज एक्स ऑफ एन, वी आर कंसीडरिंग डिस्क्रीट टाइम, आउटपुट इज वाई ऑफ एन. So according to this, if I want to write the output for the system, y of n will become operation performed on the input, t performed on the input. What is T? T is a sum operation. We don't know. It may be differentiation, integration, addition, subtraction, anything. So that operation performed on the input. Already, what is input? We have seen here. हमने already उसको generalize कर लिया है equation 1 से. So what I will do? I will substitute that value here, x of n. If I substitute that, just interchange summation or ये t के place को interchange कर दो. T operator you can apply to delta or x. I will apply it to delta. क्योंकि x आपका input signal है. I will keep it same. Summation भी same है. You see, summation same है, x same है. ये जो t operator है, that t operator I am applying it to the delta. If I do that t operator, what do you mean by this? This indicates operation is performed on the shifted impulses. Delta of n minus k means what? Shifted value of the impulses. So hum operation delta pe perform kar rahe hain, and we call this what do you mean by impulse response? जब आपका इनपुट डेल्टा हो, जो आउटपुट आपको आएगा, दैट वी कॉल इट इंपल्स रिस्पॉन्स. सी हियर, अगर आपका इनपुट, व्हेन यू आर ऑपरेटिंग, यू नो, एनी ऑपरेशन इज परफॉर्म्ड ऑन डेल्टा ऑफ टी, डेल्टा इंपल्स सिग्नल है, जो आपको आउटपुट आएगा, दैट वी कॉल इंपल्स रिस्पॉन्स एच. दैट्स व्हाई व्हेन वी गॉट दिस operation performed on the impulse, it is nothing but operation performed on one signal impulse. So kab hoga? Ye delta impulse input hai. Input agar impulse hai, output aapka impulse response hoga, h. So I will replace this complete by h of n minus k. So this complete value is replaced with h of n minus k. So that's why finally how output is written. This is very important equation. This is the base of our next concept. No doubt this derivation is not required, but you should know what are the components of the equation. That's why I took one example of five samples and I have shown you how this equation is derived. We call this convolution sum. So the next concept which we are going to study is called convolution. Okay. We will finally define it, what is convolution, but at least you first see what it is. Output y of n is equal to summation x of k h of n minus k. In generally how convolution is defined, ek signal aapka x rahega, ek signal aapka h rahega, x of n, h of n. If you put a star in between, okay, round, and don't encircle it. I have just shown you the circle for you know, indicating. Don't use the circle, just a star indicates convolution. So in signals and system, whenever you come across you know, in the problematic part, other than this real and imaginary terms, even wahan par bhi aata hai na, real part, imaginary part, usme bhi star aega top pe, but that is a different thing, that indicates a different you know, case. But yahan par jab bhi signals ke beech mein aisa koi symbol aega, that indicates convolution. It means two signals are, one is input x of n, h is your impulse signal, impulse response. In input signal, output signal, impulse response, so these three are related in this way. So what is the title? We are first dealing with the first type, that is in terms of impulse response, right? In terms of impulse response. So how we are representing here the output? Output in terms of the impulse response. So this is important one. I have derived this equation for discrete. Similarly, we can derive it for continuous as well. So continuous time ke liye kya hoga? Ye jo maine equation division mein liya hai, some continuous signal lena padega. So what I will do, jo bhi equations yahan pe hain, analogously I will change the values. You observe here. For continuous time signal, हमने यहाँ पर summation लिया था. This was our x of k, and this was delta of n minus k. इतना ही था. But continuous के लिए sum नहीं रहेगा, integration रहेगा. Input यहाँ पर x of n था earlier, okay? And x of k था. So I will take one more constant tau. you can use anything, but more conventionally in convolution continuous time mein aap tau symbol use karte hain, and this is delta of n is replaced with the time t minus k is replaced with constant tau, and as it is integration, it is with respect to d tau you should be added. So this is your equation 1. You just try to compare this equation with this equation, x of n summation x of k delta of n minus k. Similarly, analogously, I have written this. Then if I consider input x and output y and t is a sum operator, then from this system output is given by operation performed on the input, and input abhi humne equation 1 mein liya hai, that I will substitute, and in the next step I will use this operator, apply this operator on delta. See, if I apply this t operator here, only here, what this indicates, it is nothing but operation on impulse. So impulse jab aapka input hai, jab aap operation perform kar rahe ho, jo output aayega, that is called impulse response. That's why I will replace this complete value by h, which is called impulse response. It is actually, it is shifted version, but originally h of t is the impulse response. Okay, so finally how I can write the equation, y of t is equal to integration x of tau, instead of this I will replace it with h of t minus tau d tau. This is important equation we will be using throughout in the problems. This is called convolution integral. What was earlier called? It was called convolution sum, because it is discrete time, and this is called convolution integral because this is continuous time, integration is involved. And symbolically how we represent it is y of t is equal to, one input is x of t, one more signal is h of t, and the star indicates convolution. So let us now define what is convolution. Formula aapko pata hai, convolution sum ke liye ye formula hai, and convolution integral ke liye this is the formula. So as based on these equations, let me just brief you what is convolution. It is defined as the sum or integral, it is depending on this sign, either this or this. Okay, either sum or integral, sum or integral, which expresses the amount of overlap of one function, amount of overlap. So obviously if you see in both the equations you have two terms, one is x, one is h, and dono ke beech mein multiplication hai. Ek signal aapka x hai aur ek signal jo h hai wo shifted version hai, it is not h of t, it is h of t minus tau. And similarly if you see some equation mein, it is not h of n, it is h of n minus k. Second signal aapka change ho raha hai, first signal sirf simple signal hai x. Okay, so if you observe the formula, so it expresses the amount of overlap of one function when it is shifted over another function. It means aapka ek signal jo hai x, that is constant, jo aur ek signal hai h jo shifted version hai, वो सिग्नल फर्स्ट सिग्नल के ऊपर पास ऑन होगा. यू ट्राई टू इमेजिन, यू नो, एक सिग्नल फिक्स है, एक सिग्नल फिक्स है और एक सिग्नल जो है, यू विल जस्ट कीप इट ऑन द अदर सिग्नल, ओवरलैपिंग पास करते 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 निकल जाएंगे. दिस इज कॉल्ड कन्वोल्यूशन. You will understand this in a better way if I tell this convolution. You may not understand it now, but when we start solving the problems, the real meaning of convolution you'll understand. Just imagine we have two signals x and h. One signal is constant, fixed, x signal is constant, h signal is taken over the first signal, wo pass on karte karte bahar nikal jayega. This is called convolution. Now there are certain steps to be followed to perform the convolution. For tomorrow's first hour class I require this. You have to go through this, you have to go through these steps. First step, nothing much. What I have done, I have seen this formula and accordingly I have written the steps. What is the first step? I want x of tau in the formula. Originally, when a problem is given to you, they will give you x of t and h of t. That's it. They will give you these two. So how can I get x of tau? X of t is given to you. How can I get x of tau? Simply replace t by tau. You will get x of tau. This is your first step. Then observe the formula. Aapko h of t minus tau chahiye. Originally, aapko problem mein h of t denge. So it is not very simple. H of t minus tau means h of t ko le lo, usse shift kar do. No, it is not like that. It has a procedure. What we have to do is, pehle jo h of t dete hain, usko draw karke, you get h of tau first. Because tau is our main variable now. See, tau is the variable, not t. So first from h of t, find h of tau. Matlab t ko tau se replace kar do, you will get this. Once you get this, take the reflection of h of tau. You will get h of minus tau. And once you get the reflection, wo jo reflection hai h of minus tau, usme plus t add kar lo. If you want to write this in a reverse way, dekho pehle t likho, baad mein tau likho. You got this back? Right? So what I did, let me just recall. First step is x of t jo hai, originally aapko problem mein diye honge, aapko x of tau draw karna hai. Replacing t by tau. Second step, h of t denge question mein, draw h of tau. Replace t by tau. Take the reflection of this h of tau. Then jo reflection aaya hai, usme plus t ko add kar do. You will get the second signal. This is your second step. And third step, jab aapko ye dono mil gaye hain, formula mein ye dono ki requirement hai, we will get these two from first step and second step. After that, what we will do, first signal is fixed, as I told you. First signal is fixed. And what to do? The second signal should be overlapped for different time ranges. Main second signal ko leti hoon. Like this, I will just keep on shifting the signal over the first signal, you know, karte karte nikal jaungi bahar. So this is the way how we find convolution. There are three steps involved majorly. We have to follow these three steps to perform the convolution. You can see it on the left hand side. I have written these steps for continuous time. Similarly, we can write for discrete time. For discrete time, what are the changes? Instead of x of tau, aapko x of k chahiye. So x of n se aap x of k draw karo, replace n by k. Then humko ye second signal chahiye. For that, I will start with h of n. Ye given rehta hai question mein. I will get h of k. Just n ko k se replace kar do. Then take the reflection of this. Then take the shifting. So once you get these two, baad mein kya karna hai? Ek signal ko fix rakhna hai. Keep one signal fixed. Take the second signal. And second signal should be passed on over the first signal, overlap over different time ranges, and it should be passed on. So this is how we find the convolution. Okay. For tomorrow's first hour class, I want these two procedures. I will be starting with this. Okay?